Welcome. In this video, we will be simulating demand from this discrete probability distribution using data table, lookup, VLOOKUP, and RANDARRAY in Excel. Let's begin by creating random number intervals for cumulative probabilities. The lower limit for the first interval will be 0, while the upper limit will be the probability for the first demand level. Moving forward, the lower limit for each interval will equal the upper limit for the preceding interval, and the upper limit for each interval will be the lower limit plus the probability at that demand level. Select both lower and upper limits for the second interval and copy the formulas down for the remaining probabilities. Let's shade the intervals yellow and make the demands bold. The first interval will ensure that random numbers from 0 to less than 0.09 will produce a demand of 50. Random numbers from 0.09 to less than 0.24 will produce a demand of 100, and so on. Next, let's create a random number here that will be used to simulate a demand level to the right here. For the random number, we use the function equals rand with nothing within the parentheses. The rand function produces a number that is equally likely to assume any value between 0 and 1. This value will change each time we hit the return key, press F9, or recalculate. Now, for the simulated demand, we will use two approaches, the lookup and the VLOOKUP functions. Let's begin with the lookup here. For the lookup value, select the random number, comma. For the lookup vector, select the lower limit of the cumulative probability intervals, comma, and for the result vector, select the demand values. Enter. You can see that it simulated a demand of 150 because the random number of 0.58 generated falls in the probability interval for the 150 demand level. Let's shade the simulated demand cell light green. Next, we run 1,000 trials of this simulation and determine the mean and standard deviation of the replications. We will be using both data table and RANDARRAY approaches. Let's type trial beside the simulated value, then 1 under it. Keep the cursor under 1 and under the Home tab to the right under Editing, click on Fill. Then click Series. We want the series to start at 1, increase in steps of 1, and stop at 1000. We also want it in a column and not in a row. Click OK. And Excel creates the series from 1 to 1000. Now, to use data table to replicate the 1000 trials, select trial and the simulated demand. Control Shift down arrow to select all the way down to the 1000th trial. Click the Data tab. Click What If Analysis. Select Data Table. Since the trials are listed in a column, click in the column input cell. Then click on an empty cell that will not be used for any other purpose. This essentially tells Excel to compute the formula 1000 times with a random number changing each time. Click OK. And Excel has replicated the results 1000 times. That is, it has used different random numbers to produce different demand levels. Note that 120 and 150 have the highest probabilities here. Therefore, we expect them to appear more often than 50 and 200, which have the least probabilities. Next, we compute the mean and standard deviation of the simulated demand values. For mean equals average, click on the first value. Control Shift down arrow to select all the way down. Enter. For the standard deviation, let's use the sample standard deviation formula. Select the data. Enter. Now let's use VLOOKUP to generate similar results. Type equals VLOOKUP. For the lookup value, select the random number, comma. For the table array, select the lower limit up to demand, comma. We don't really need these upper limits, but we include them because they fall in the middle of the table. For the column index number, we enter 3, indicating that the third column contains the result we want to see, the demand values. Enter. What that did was to look for the random number in these lower limit values, then returns the corresponding demand from the third column selected. Now I'm going to use RandArray to generate the same results. Equals VLOOKUP, RandArray, comma, select the table, comma, then 3 for the demand column. Enter. Using RandArray like that without any argument functions simply like rand. Now to make it generate 1000 replications, we simply need to give RandArray the argument 1000. Note that we can do this with the lookup function as well. Enter. And that's 1000 replications. Now to compare the mean and standard deviation, let's select the mean and SD here and drag to the right. You can see that the mean of the two replications are close, and so are the standard deviations. And that's how to apply Monte Carlo simulation to discrete probability distributions in Excel. Thanks for watching.